A concrete foundation mat in the shape of a regular hexagon with 3 meter side supports column loads as shown in the figure. Determine the magnitude of the additional loads P1 and P2 that must be applied at B and F. Okay. If the resultant of all 6 forces is to pass through the center of the mat. Okay. See, now in this problem they have not given us the magnitude of the resultant. Okay. I mean, we all know the magnitude of the resultant is going to be P1 plus P2 plus 80 plus 40 plus 60 plus 100. So that will be P1 plus P2 plus 280. Okay, but that is not, I think, what they have asked. They want us to find the magnitudes of P1 and P2. And the condition which is going to help us in solving that problem is the resultant of all 6 loads is to pass through the center of the mat, which is the origin. Now we can directly apply the Varignon's theorem here. Which states that sum of the moments of the individual forces 6 about some point, and here we are taking that point to be origin, is equal to moment due to the result about the same point. Now if we are taking moments about origin, then moment due to resultant must be a null vector. Why? Because they are saying that resultant is to pass through the center of the mat, and center of the mat is this origin. Okay, so the right hand side is going to be a null vector. Alright. So we need to find out the coordinates of points A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay. So let's start with point A. Point A is, its coordinates will be, yeah, side is 3, right? So x coordinate is minus 3, y and z are 0. Correct, because it lies on the negative x axis. Okay. Now let's go to point B. Point B is in the zx plane. In fact, all 6 points are in the zx plane. So its y coordinate must be equal to 0. Okay. Now, if we draw the top view of this hexagon, it will look something like this. Okay, this is the positive x and this is the positive z. Okay, and this is point A, this is point B, this is C, this is D, this is E, and this is F. Now if we find out coordinates of point B using the sign convention, we can easily find out the coordinates of C, E, and F. Alright. So let's join the origin and this point. Correct? Now clearly this is a right, this is an equilateral triangle. Triangle OAB. Why it is an equilateral triangle? Because two of its sides are same. OA and OB, OA and AB rather, and this angle is 60, right? So triangle OAB is an equilateral triangle. See, it is equilateral only because the hexagon is regular. That means all its sides are equal. Fine. So let's just zoom in. This is O, this is A, and this is B. Now if I drop a perpendicular from B on negative x axis, let me call that point as P. Then the directed distance OP is going to be the x coordinate of B. Alright? And the directed distance PB is going to be its z coordinate. Now from this figure you can clearly see that the x coordinate of B is going to be negative and the z coordinate will be positive. Okay. Now if this angle is 60, then OP must be equal to OB cos 60, correct? And cos 60 is 1 upon 2, so this is 1.5. But this being a directed distance, we must include a negative sign as well, because that is along negatives. Okay. So if the x coordinate of B is minus 1.5, its z coordinate will be 3 sine 60, which will be 3 into root 3 by 2. That is 2.598. Okay. Now coordinates of point C. Now to find the coordinates of point C, we need to take a note of the fact that C lies in that quadrant where x is positive and so is z. Okay, so the coordinates of C will be plus 1.5, 0, plus 2.59. Okay, D lies on x-axis, so its coordinates will be 3, 0, 0. Now E lies in that quadrant where x is positive and z is negative. Correct? And F lies in that quadrant where both Z and X are negative. So coordinates of F will be minus 1.5, 0, minus 2.59. Now we can find the sum of the moments of all these forces about origin. Okay. Therefore, applying Varignon's theorem, we'll get 0 bar is equal to, because we know that right hand side is 0. Fine. So we need to write down 6 determinants. I cap, J cap, K cap. Let's start with point A. Point A carries a force of 80 kilonewtons along negative y, so the third row will be 0 minus 80, 0, that's F1. And now what are the coordinates of A? They are minus 3, 0, 0. So OA bar will automatically be minus 3 I cap, plus 0 J cap, plus 0. Then let's go to the force which is being applied at point B, which is P1. Now if its magnitude is P1, we must write it as 0 minus P1, 0, because that is again along negative y. And now the coordinates of B, which are minus 1.5, 0, and 2.598, and the first row will be I cap, J cap, and K cap. Okay, plus third determinant, I cap, J cap, K cap. Let's go to point C now. So it is minus 40, which is acting at C. 0, minus 40, 0. Now coordinates of point C, 1.5, 0, 2.598. Plus next point D. D's coordinates are 3, 0, 0. And which force is acting at D? 100 kilonewton force. So 0 minus 100 0 plus I cap j cap k cap. Now moment due to the force at E, which is 60. So 0 minus 60 is 0, and coordinates of E are 1.50 minus 2.598, and now the last determinant, and that will obviously involve P2, which is at F. So coordinates of F are minus 1.50 minus 2.598, and the third row will be 0 minus P2 0. Therefore 0 I cap plus 0 j cap plus 0 k cap, which is the moment due to the resultant, is equal to. So let's begin by expanding the determinants. I cap into 0 minus j cap into 0 plus k cap into 240. Okay, plus next this force, I cap into 0 minus 2.598 into minus P1, so that will be I cap into plus 2.598 P1 minus J cap into 0 plus K cap into 1.5 P1, correct? 1.5 and minus third
J0.
Yes. Plus third is I cap into 40 into 2.598, j cap is 0 by default, plus k cap into minus 40 into 1.5, plus fourth one now, I cap into 0 minus, and both these things have a negative sign, so 3 negative signs mean 1 negative sign, so 60 into 2.598 minus j cap into 0 plus k cap into 1.5 into minus 60, and now the last one. Or did we miss any? This is the first one, second, third. Yeah, I think we missed this. Right? K cap. Yeah, okay, fine. Let me write it here. The third one, that is 0 I cap, 0 j cap, minus 300 k cap. Okay. And now the last one. Plus I cap into minus P2 into 2.598. Is it right? Yes. Because this is 0 into 0, so 0 minus, this will be plus. Okay. Minus J cap into 0 plus K cap into 1.5 P2. Okay. Therefore, equating the x components, zero is equal to 2.598 P1 plus 40 into 2.598 minus 60 into 2.598 minus 2.598 P2. So you need to get one more equation, and now we will equate the z components. 0 is equal to 240 plus 1.5 P1 minus 300 minus 40 into 1.5 minus 60 into 1.5 plus 1.5 P2. Now we can write the matrix equation now. Let's call the unknowns as x and y. So let x be equal to P1 and let y be equal to P2. The coefficients of P1 and P2 in the first equation are 2.598 and minus 2.598. The coefficients of P1 and P2 in the second equation are 1.5 and 1.5, okay. And now the constant terms. All these terms, when they go on the other side, they'll become positive. Now this is 40 minus 60, which is minus 20. So this will be plus 20 into 2.598. And this will be 100 into 1.5, this one, plus 300 minus 240. Therefore, P1 is 80 and P2 is 60. What are the units? Units given in the problem were kilonewtons. So P1 is 80 kilonewtons and P2 is 60 kilonewtons. Now let's quickly find out the magnitude of the resultant. P1 plus P2 is 80 plus 60 plus this is 280. That is 280 plus 140. So that is 420. I mean, they have not asked that, but still, they have found it. Okay, fine.